Smart Wargames here. After covering some classic games, let's return to current games, and I have some new GTS games, John Tiller Software games, for you to showcase. And yes, thanks to GTS to let me check out those games. And first we will cover Squad Battles First World War. I've already did some videos on the Squad Battle series, quite impressed of it. Just discovered it recently, and yes, let me set the sound. Yeah, what is unique about this game? It is World War One, and while there are many games, many options that cover the operational or strategic aspect of World War One, World War One covered on a tactical scale, on the other hand, at least to my knowledge, there are not many games. So it is one of those unique games and a great idea. Yes, first where you can get this game from the main page of John Tiller Software, First World War. Check out the features. And this game was recently overhauled. Some of the screenshots you see are the classic graphics, but it was recently overhauled with some new visuals. Yeah, let me do a sound check. 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 Okay, should be fine. Check. Okay, should be fine. Good. Yes, about this game, I will show you what you features and give you an overview. Before we check the game, let's go into the installation folder. Yes, as for many GTS games, first you have the option to switch to classic graphics. In the notes folder, you will find a zip file or containing the original graphics, and you can also mix and match them. I didn't check out what mods might be available, but for example, I like info means. It is this interface area with information and visuals, and map is for the tactical map. And for example, I like those side silhouettes of vehicles. So I'm going to copy it and yeah, make a backup beforehand. And then you go into the info folder here and can replace the top down by the side silhouettes, which I did right now. Yes, what has this game to offer from a technical aspect? Like with the other John Tiller games, you have the ability to edit hard, what I call hard data, like how effective our weapon systems and ammunition are. I always welcome this player choice. So you can set up some house rules for your multiplayer or for your own play. Then, of course, you have a scenario editor. Everything comes with documentation. You have a map editor, a master map editor, I guess, and a submap editor. But you can also change general parameters of the game, how elevation is perceived, and movement costs, etc. So this game comes with a lot of options also for modding, so if you're interested in this, check it out. Good. Next, before we go into the game, we will check out, because I think it's a good idea, it works good, what is this game coming with? We already see here the factions. We will see the Americans, the American Marines, Australians, Hungarians, British, Canadian, French, German, Italian or Allied, Russian, Turkish. So the complete World War One, not the complete war, but the major players of World War One are represented. And yeah, let's check the infographics because I think it's always a good way to showcase you the weapon systems, etc. I'm not an expert on World War One weapon systems, but some of you might be interested what you might see in this game. We have some aircraft. Gun systems, they are now top down. I could also guess install a side vision for them. Perhaps I will do it. Check out if there is a option for this. Guns. Guns. Guns here. Yeah. Sometimes this Windows picture viewer, I don't know what the heck is going on with it. Open it with paint. Old tool always working. Yeah, I might install this one. I really like those side pictures. Yeah, let's bring this with me and then continue to check out the TOE and the equipment info. Okay. Yeah, I will change the paint. Ah, you know what? Don't bother with it. Come on, let's go. Yeah, this is some heavy artillery pieces represented in the game. Next, we have heavy weapon and support weapons. Mortar systems, machine gun systems. Infantry guns and some support weapons, marksman weapons. And yeah, you see, you also have the ability here to do some editing, I guess. Equipment. Here, geballte Ladung. What is it called in English? It is basically a charge containing multiple warheads in order to make it more powerful. Vehicles. World War One, of course, didn't have that much tanks, but they are represented. It was a appearance of armored warfare. And yeah, there are some really exciting models here. But you also have old school horses and even riverine vehicles. Yeah, this is really unique. Not often portrayed. I can't recall any war game on a tactical scale focus on World War One tactical action. Vehicle weapons, and here we will now come to the regular weapons, to the infantry weapons, small arms. Yeah. Interesting options here, even a sword. Even they were still presented in trench warfare, having a sword is of course handy if stuff is about to hit the fan. Okay, that's checking out what the game has to offer from a technical aspect. Now let's one thing we will start check out before we will go into the main program is it as comes with a campaign program, and there's a plenty of campaigns which seems to be focused on individuals, which I always enjoy. We have a option for Canadian Army. We have an option for South African Army. Not often seen. Australian. British, US, Marine, US Army, German, Unteroffizier eben. Ja, das ist interesting. Unteroffizier ist a Sergeant. That's interesting. How this plays out. Are you commanding something like a Unteroffizier ist usually a team leader. Can also be a squad leader. Yes. Let's check it out. Would be interesting to see if you have a small team. I sometimes enjoy those small scale actions because you're focusing on every detail. Every weapon becomes important. Every command becomes important. But I already checked it out. You can also go really crazy. I think it might be one of the biggest squad battle games, as World War One, of course, was a big clash of human and material resources. Check this out. Ooh, quite a long campaign, and look at this, it goes really long. I like this. This is really the chronicles of this sergeant. Let's check it out. Yeah, and you can even play those campaigns, as you see, PBEM, played email. Never did it, but seems they might be balanced and you can do it, yeah. We are Unteroffizier Wilhelm, Grenadierregiment 119. Division Württemberg. And you might be promoted in the course of action. And let's check out how the first mission looks like. This would be perhaps a good introduction campaign if it is playing out. Could be, of course, that you play a role play a person in a bigger, but command on a bigger scale. And I also already checked some of the briefings out. They look quite extensive. Would be, of course, great if the interface could be... No way. Oh, but there is... This is new. Unfortunately, it isn't doing anything. So this would be, of course... This can a general thing about GTS games, that some of the windows, if they would be, could be resized and perhaps the fonts increased, would be, of course, great. But look at this. This is written in a novel style, which I really welcome. War games need exactly aspects like this, more immersive and narrative elements. I won't read completely through it, also in order not to spoiler me, because I will do a playthrough of this. But I love stuff like this. Some of them of my most favorite combat mission campaigns also come with exactly this elements. Yeah, good briefing. Check out. Yeah, we have the options, you know, from other squad battle games. For people that don't like the random component, you can engage optional fire results and assault results, which means that a second calculation will be done and the result of the first and the second calculation will be averaged. It's a basic mathematic principle to eliminate extremes, you know, if you throw a dice 5 times, you might end up with a different average than if you throw the dice, I don't know, 10 times, because you're increasing the sample, and the bigger the sample, the less random your average will be. And yeah, vehicle fire over, interesting option, not sure if I would select it for World War One. It is basically meaning that vehicles can fire across infantry units or over infantry units. It is choice. I think many of those tanks in World War One, they were rather low. But sure, if somebody is lying in cover in front, you might fire over them, and I think in World War One they didn't give that much consideration about safety, or less consideration about safety than they do today. Today, firing over infantry is, depending on the army and depending on the conditions, in wartime conditions, of course, stuff is different. But it is, let's say, it is not practice every day, because it always involves dangers, even with smaller calibers. The unbearable ending is that the turn times might be randomized a bit, that they might be increased. Okay. Yeah, and that's the new visuals. I really like those icons, and yeah, you definitely are commanding on a greater scale than a Unteroffizier would do. You are basically a piece of the bigger action. This is Unteroffizier Wilhelm. He is, I guess here with his, he's leading a, he's leading two platoons. Why not? Unteroffiziers, I can't tell about World War One, but us in the modern German army, Unteroffizier, Tapped us in World War II, that definitely us could come into the position to lead a platoon. Because always was, not always, but at least from what I know of, since World War II, leadership training was in the German army always important, also on the lower. On the lower hierarchy, they were trained to handle themselves and to handle others, even above their usual role. Yeah, but it's definitely a greater scale, and this game is a bigger scale as World War One also was a battle between big forces. Okay, that's about the campaigns. We check them out. Now we will go into the main game. And I will go with the mouse. I won't read everything here out, but some might be interested in specific battles. And yeah, I will go through the scenario list and you can check for yourself. As you notice, a lot of those scenarios are campaign style, connected in some sense, which I welcome. I'm not a big fan of isolated single scenarios. Also more the fan of campaigns. So this is because you could play them like a campaign, start with first and then move on. And you see a lot of fronts, and we will play the getting started scenario. I already have prepared the getting started PDF, which is so typical for GTS games, that you have a getting started scenario and supplemented documentation for it. However, it is what I've noticed in the squad battles, which also of course makes sense, this documentation, so I mean I can show it to you. We need to start as the allies and put the central powers on AI. I think I will play with the default rules. Let's go. Yeah, what is important? Chemical weapons, which played a role in World War One, as most know, also are represented. Okay, aircraft went over and fired into something. Yes, that's the Allies. We are currently sitting in our trenches with some Renault tanks, I guess ready for an assault attempt. And yeah, I will, maybe, what is here, the victory points? Let's check it out. And let's remove the taskbar to have a bigger interface. Okay, first, before we will start, I will show you the interface. Viewers that are already familiar with squad battles or with other GTS games, they should of course recognize a lot. But yeah, okay, these are basic commands like saving, turn, command, like hold fire and toggle on ground. By the way, numblock 0 is the hotkey for toggling it on the ground. Thanks again for mentioning this. This is a comment you might often need. Leaders, air artillery support. A leader might be new. Air artillery support. Yeah, no, that's fine. I mean, I think in other games also leaders need to call in. Let's see, do we have? No air and artillery support. Yeah, scheduled units, etc. Information, comment, rolling barrage. That might be new. What is this? Yeah, that is interesting. That is also typical for World War One. If I interpret this correctly, what they often do, I mean, they did it also in later wars, but artillery was of not that highly coordinated with army or with other troops like it perhaps was in the later wars. They scheduled barrages and the assault or the ground war evolved around them. So for example, the first they hit those lines with artillery for, I don't know, let's say 10 minutes, then you advanced, there was a pause for 20 minutes or whatever, and then they shifted the fire 100 meters into the back, stuff like this. Yeah, I guess this is what you can understand in a rolling barrage. Weapons off. What is this? Ah, weapons off is, yeah, sure. In squad battles, units lose weapons. They might lie on the ground. Map contours. Yeah, this is helpful, I think, because otherwise you might have... I mean, sure, you can't see it always here, but this contours, of course, help. For example, there is a elevation here. We are lying, but these guys are lying behind. No, they are on a hill. They are on a hill. So this is always helpful. And it is a descending terrain. Good. What have we else for settings? Show organization. Yeah. OOB. We are the Americans Gas Regiment. What are these guys doing? Tank Battalion and Arty. What is that these guys are doing? Stokes mortar, okay. They fire gas. Interesting. Shade. Hexes on range. Visible hexes. Yeah, this is something, I guess this is S. Yeah, S is a very important command. It gives you the visualization of what a unit sees, which is really important information. Highlight, okay. Yeah, we can do commanded units. I sometimes like to highlight this organization, I think. Yeah, exactly, that's what I'm looking for. In order to keep units together, if you see immediately which units I belong, because I really like keeping cohesion. This, I guess, is a company, for example. You can keep those guys together. Yeah, let's leave it this way. I think this is the most important information for highlight right now. And yeah, this game comes with different visuals. You don't only have this ability, this graphics mode, but you can also switch in some sort of tabletop 3D mode with which tabletop figurines and play like this. Who prefers it? Different visuals, everything can be modded. Yeah, fast AI processing, we might need to enable. But I showed you hotkeys F, without warranty, F5, 6, 7, 8 speed controls, which you can fine tune your speed. I prefer this way more than this fast AI processing, because you still are left with sound and everything. Yeah, multiplayer stuff. Beep on error, let's remove that, I don't need it. Yeah, interesting is that this game comes with a PBEM encryption for cheater protection, because PBEM normally is rather prone to getting cheated upon. But usually you play, of course, with people that don't do stuff like this. Bleed to, you can also use NATO symbols. This might be interesting for some. Yeah, alternate graphics not installed, but you can install alternate graphics. For example, you could. There's a separate folder in the map folder. It called alt or something, and you can put graphics files in there, which you desire. Can basically have two settings, and then if you hit this, they will immediately change. For example, you could use the old graphics, the legacy graphics, put them into alt, and yeah, have your portraits. That's also what I wanted to show, because I know some people prefer the portraits. They are not gone. You still have them. And this, for example, you could put into your alt folder, in order to have those faces. Wait, it's a bit low resolution. Yeah, because some think they are more according their taste. You can do it, but you can also only use those faces in the info interface. Simply use those, for example, unit files. Just for it. You can mix and match as you desire. This is really well handled. Okay, yeah. And I currently have this documentation open, getting started. If you start a game, check this out. But for streaming, it is a lot of text, like for the other squad battle games, as tactical action often involves a lot of considerations. And if players are not well into tactical knowledge and knowledge of this period of the weapon systems involved, and sure, you need of course more text to describe it, which is completely fine. I won't read through everything, I will try to freestyle it. Yeah, I currently have it open on another screen. And yeah, these are the victory points here. So it is basically clear that we are the assaulting force and will attack. Okay, give me a moment to check out with what we want to start. I still would wish if the... It is okay the details and everything to provide them, but that at least the instructions are somehow highlighted or separated from the text. And I don't know, either with bold or with separate. Only the instructions and the explanations, they can be stay like this. Because otherwise it reads more like a novel. Yeah, it looks like we will start with some distant fire, artillery fire, even chemical fire. Cool. Okay, ja. Yeah. I get it. We are talking about those mortars here, and you can select a weapon load for weapons like this. Must be also a button for it. This here. Yeah. And yeah, they already are selected chemical rounds. I always wanted to see this game being played. Yeah, then be my guest. We will immediately get into the topic of chemical warfare, and we'll try to hit those bunkers with chemical rounds in order to hamper their effectiveness. So let's check. They don't see those bunkers, but they can still fire at it with reduced precision. And you see it created indeed a chemical cloud. But of course we need to hit it. Yeah. By accident somebody else was. Those guys might now put on their use a secret weapon, have the Brits run across the battlefield dribbling a football like they did at some. Okay, that's it. We fired everything. Yeah, we hit at least some in the trenches. They might now put on their masks. Masks are also represented in this game. But we have more mortars. I will still try to hit those bunkers. Let's check if the weapon load is correct. Hello? Looks like they don't have a weapon load. Okay, they're also firing chemical rounds. Good hit. Yeah, this should help. Let's see, where else do we have a bunker? Or some machine gun perhaps. Mauser. You might not see all weapons of the enemy, it's only the identified weapons. Yeah, this guy definitely has a machine gun. And these guys as well, so let's try to hit them. Okay, worked out. Oh. And you see, with visual, this guy has visual on those trenches. It is way easier to fire precisely. Yeah, some long-range machine gun fire. Good, let's see what we have else here. Is this mortar loaded with chemicals? No, but it is loaded with something. So I don't care. Fire. This is definitely some. Yeah, it is a bunker. However, firing on a bunker. What is this? What is the ammunition of this guy? HE or what? Yeah, let's test it out. Yeah, looks like HE. So firing on bunkers might do nothing. We will fire into those trenches here. I have, yeah, smoke. He is not equipped with smoke. No. Okay, they got pinned. But they might be pinned beforehand already. Receiving some fire. Okay, and this guy is also. It looks like only the 4-inch mortars can fire those. The special stuff. Let's find a good target for it. Pinned, disrupted, disrupted. This is a bit. It's fine. This machine gun position. You can't see it, unfortunately. Or this mortar position here. But if he can't see it, it's unlikely he will hit it. So we might stay on this position here. And this machine gun position here. Okay, mortars are fired. Let's Okay. Like I said, I won't follow the tutorial, because it's simply from... But if you play it, do it. Ah, yeah, the tanks will next open fire. And they also, those Renaults with their 37mm, they also carry different ammunitions. HE canister. And what is SH? SH would be good for ranged fire against any non-hulk targets such as infantry or heavy weapons. AP is good against bunkers. And CA canister is should be used at 1 hex range. Okay. Roger that. Good. I might stay with AP and we will fire into those bunkers. Is this bunker even... Yeah, we don't know if somebody's inside there, I guess. Yeah, this bunker needs to be suppressed. Firing on my tank. Good, where's the next bunker? Here. And this... What? This tank just explode. Yeah, it happens, but one tanks are not the absolutely. Yeah. Did they fire machine gun? I mean, sure, you can. I could imagine you can disable tanks as with machine gun fire. Some of those early like tanks, definitely. Just wonder if they fired. Yeah, I guess they fired with the machine guns. Mr. Maxim MG8 and disabled this Renault. Yeah, another 37mm. Yeah, they are disrupted by the gas. Can you see the spunk? Can you see this bunker? No. Okay, then fire into the gassed bunker. With AP rounds, okay. And now the tutorial wants us not to assault, but to wait. Yeah. Let's follow it. And wait also for the barrage. All units are in cover. You see it by this white. Let's go. I could also issue auto fire. Do I want this? I guess so. Perhaps not. I mean, we should have waited for the artillery. Yeah, I can speed up. I think it was, wait, F6 or F7. It is F6, you see it's speeding up. Another one. F6 isn't a button. It seems the speed controls are gone. What do I'm pressing the wrong buttons now. That's interesting. Perhaps they changed the buttons. Yeah, first casualty. And speed it up. But could be that there's a triggered a major firefight. Not sure if it was good. We should have waited for the RT. Not just because you can't fire doesn't mean you should fire. On the other hand, it might help us suppressing them when the RT incomes. That was a little exchange in World War One. Is the hotkeys listed? Because still looking for the speed. F7. It's still this group here, but it could be different for this AI shooting. Should have better not opened up, because if you're assaulting, you might need them to be fresh, and but might as well put some stress on the Germans. Let's see what will happen. And yeah, I wanted to damn it, that's what I'm talking about. This is faster. AI processing is very fast. You see currently there's a firefight going on, but it is way too fast. But you can create, if I can deactivate this button, I might not manage it. Ah, now, okay. And now you can improve the speed with F7, I guess. Yeah, you see? And this is for me the perfect setting. You still can follow the action, but it doesn't take ages. And you have sound. With fast processing, you have this silent super speed calculation. Yeah, quite a fire effect. And it is arty incoming. Bias removed by accident. No way! Did you see it? Yeah, it happens. The blast of the arty was that big that it destroyed our own tank. Good. Now I think in the meanwhile I read through the tutorial, and yeah, this leaving a lot of options open, and we basically did everything that, and now we need to get into the trenches. Yeah, unfortunately we lost another tank here. The center has no armored support. And yeah, check again this rolling barrage thing, just to make sure that we won't run into our own barrage. Let's start the tanks first. Not sure, do I want to move that close? I don't think so. Yeah, here we might could achieve a breach here. We of course need to watch out, there's this bunker. Nah, not, what is it below? Wires, right? Thank you. Should also think about using smoke, but perhaps not yet. Is this guy? Oh, one man down. Is this gas spreading? Seems so. Not that we run into our own gas, which also often happened. They blew the. In World War One, there was often gas-friendly fire because of misjudged wind and etc. You can put masks on if required. Be better to stay prone all the time. I was thinking the Germans are going for a counter-attack, but not sure what they did there. Because you heard the sound cues in the background. So something happened. Perhaps a retreat movement. Okay. Yeah, we secured a foothold in front of the first trench line. Looks like the arty is shifting to the barrage towards the rear elements of the Germans. Some good hits there, a lot of misses. But it seems here the gas is spreading. Even one of our units is... Nah, it's a bunker. But either we go in this gas mask, which you can trigger here. But I didn't want to make the video too long. I think it gave a good overview about what you can expect from this game, and it is quite different from the other squad battle games, as World War One was also very different from Future Wars. Okay. That's it. See you.